In the last lesson, we designed and built a query using the query design command. Now we'll build another query, but this time we'll add an extra function that helps summarize our results. Then we'll sort and filter our query results to define them even more. Okay, now this time, let's build a query to find out what category of books we sell most often. Start by thinking about what we want our results to look like. This will help us know what we need. We want to see the title, the author's first name and last name, the category, and the price of our best-selling books. And maybe we'd even want to see the number of times each book was ordered. If we decide we don't want this information once we've run the query, we can always go back and delete it. But it's a good idea to include everything you think you might want while you're planning the query, so we'll include it in our plan. Next, identify the tables we'll need. This time, we'll just need the orders table and the books table. Finally, think about the conditions we need our data to meet. We will want to see only the books that show up in the orders table, and we want to know which book's ID number shows up most often there, so we need to count how often each book ID appears in the orders table. All right, we have our plan, so let's get started. From the Create tab, select the Query Design command. Pick which tables of queries you want to use as a basis for the new query. We need the books table and the orders table, so pick those from the list. From the books table, we want everything except the book ID. Now we need the book ID from the orders table, so we'll drag that down too. Now this makes sure we have a list of all the books we ordered. Here is where our count comes in. Now if we click Run right now, we see one record for each time a book was ordered. Well, Access can group the records with the same book ID and give us a count for each one. To do that, let's go back to Design View and click the Totals command. This makes an entire new row, the Total row, and it appears in the Query Design window. Now by default, this row sets everything to group by something. But all we're really concerned with is the count, so that's what we're going to change. Now, in the Total cell for Book ID, click on the drop down and select Count. This is how we tell Access to count the number of times each book ID appears in the orders table. Now when we click Run, we get a column that tells us how many times each book has appeared in the orders table. It has grouped each book's title, author, price, and category to show up only one time in the results, and it shows us the number of times a book ID appears in the orders table. Now, if you pay close attention, you'll notice that the last column says count of book ID, but in Design View, it just said book ID. I just wanted to point that out so it wouldn't be confusing. Now, we can go back and change the design of the query to sort the count highest to lowest or descending so we can see which books were ordered most at the top. We could also change the design to filter for certain categories if we wanted to know what technology titles sell the best, for example. Now back in our query design view, we add the criteria of technology for the category field. Now this whole row is called criteria. It filters your data based on the criteria you set here. Now let's save this query as our best sellers by category. So now you've seen how you can create and modify queries in order to answer the questions you may have about your data. But you also saw that the data that is returned doesn't look very nice if you had to formally share them with someone else. Our next lesson will show you how to run reports and how to format them to look good to other people.